if you had to summarize whatever it is that you're doing for as long as you've been doing it in just a few sentences, would you be able to do that? I got into this conversation with a friend of mine just a few days ago, and he asked me, all right, you've been doing that for 10, 12, whatever years. What are the most important parts of your business? If I were to start trading today, what would be your advice to me? I really hope at least one of you is going to take at least one bullet point of this presentation, and it will save you money. Let's stop wasting time jumping into the first one. Emotions do not help in trading. You must understand that. I don't care if you're religious. I don't care if you're praying to 15 gods, right? Emotions, feelings, hopes do not have place in trading. They do not have place in business in general. Take them out of your trading plan and throw them away, okay? Pack it up today, right now, and the next time you're feeling emotional about a trade, stop immediately. Rewind and try to make sure whatever it is you're doing in your trading terminal, there is no emotion involved in your trading decision. Super important, all right? Next one, if I can click here, risk management. I know this is a subject which everyone, everywhere, in every single book, webinar, seminar is talking about. Yet, over 80% of the traders, 75 to 90%, depending on the statistics, are losing money. Why? This is what I'm trying to understand. How can you be told by someone who did exactly the same mistake like you did, and I'm telling you, one-to-one, right? Do not do that. You will lose money if you do it. Yet people are doing it. How does it happen? People are amazing. Anyhow, risk management is the super important part of trading. This is the foundation of trading that you must understand, and not just understand, you must follow it and apply it to your trading, okay? This is the part where you understand how to protect your money. This is the part where you understand you cannot put all of the money in a single trade. That's the idea of risk management. Moving forward, following blindly other people, mentors, copy traders, whatever it is out there in the internet, plenty of options. You can be doing that, and you will be doing fine probably for some time. But at the end of the day, what happens when your mentor or copy trader or whatever it is you're following blindly is gone, right? The guy retires or the copy trader moves into another direction and he stops providing you with the signals. What do you do then? Let's say you've been doing that for 1 year, 2 years, you've been making money consistently. All right, perfect. Now you go ahead and quit your daytime job. You take all your savings, you put them in this trading service. Fantastic. 6 months later, gone. All right? The scheme is over. What do you do next? This is my question. The idea of trading is, and all these books and mentors and everything else that you're going to see online, to educate you how to become a trader. If you want to be investing and not trading yourself, there are other ways to do that, right? In the Forex business, intraday retail trading, this is probably not the best option for you. Even if you're following someone, the idea is to go ahead and understand why are these trades happening? What stands or what sits behind the decision to open a buy or a sell. Do not blindly follow people if you want to be a real trader. If you do that, okay, you will remain blind for trading for always. Education, educate yourself. Now, this part is interesting and it will probably benefit people who are just starting now. The idea is to start with free materials, but materials which are proven to work. Start with baby pips if you wish, right? Or start with my website. There will be education there soon as well. Get the free stuff and understand what is in the whole bubble of trading. Because when we say trading, people are imagining the Wolf of Wall Street, buying, selling, we make money, we become millionaires. Fantastic. No. This big niche, this big category of trading has many, many sub-niches or sub-categories inside of it. So you need to find in which sub-category you belong. I'm talking about, are you an intraday trader? Are you a person who wants to be doing algorithmic trading? You want to be developing algorithms and you want to be doing it this way? Are you a person who is willing to do a bit more thorough research based on the situation that you have currently and then pull the trigger? That means you're a swing trader. So start reading, testing in the beginning, see where you belong. Once you understand your position and your subcategory, then start investing money for more education, quality, software, if you will, okay? But not in the beginning. In the beginning, you will be throwing money in every direction, but you have no clue what you're doing. I know everyone is in a rush to make money, but patience is the key, guys. You cannot be, and girls, you cannot be extremely rushed into the situation because you will end up losing money. And patience applies to each and all of these. I think it's 10 slides that I have prepared for you today. Next thing is to stop hopping from strategy to strategy, from course to course, from idea to idea, from method to method. This step, by the way, is happening. Number 5 is happening because people are not doing number 4 correct. You have no idea what's happening. You're always pressed by the FOMO, right? The fear of missing out. Someone made money buying Bitcoin. Another guy made money mining Ethereum. Another guy made money doing this. You're constantly chasing ghosts. It will not happen. You have no idea who these guys are. Most of the time, maybe they're your friends, I don't know, but most of the time, you have no clue what these people are doing. How many years of experience they have in this specific niche, okay? Maybe this guy was mining since 2012. How do you know that? He knows things you have no clue, all right? He's not probably going to share these things with you. So now you go ahead and you buy this expensive ASIC miner, you pay $10,000, 6 months later, the algorithm changes, and you have no clue what to do with this expensive hardware. And yet, you're losing money again. Same thing is happening with the trading. I mean, I don't know why I went to crypto and hardware and mining, but this is the idea, okay? You need to become proficient in one small single method, one single strategy. You need to be the absolute expert. You gotta be the best guy in the world doing just that. Take Japanese candlesticks. Probably most of you heard about that. And now once you take this subcategory, we now have probably 14, 15, 20 subcategories inside the Japanese candlesticks. Now your job is to understand how each and every single one of these patterns work. What time frames, what is the winning percentage, what markets are best for which pattern, and then you have a winning strategy. Then you start making money. Because maybe in your findings, you will understand that bullish engulfing works best on Amazon stock. Just for instance, you deploy this strategy on your trading terminal and you know that statistics are there. It's backed by raw data and you're gonna make money. But if you start taking, you read a book, engulfing is when the candle this does, when the candle does this and that, and you have two candles, let's go make money. Stop for a second. Do you have an idea who wrote the book? when the book was written. How many years ago was that? What kind of markets did they trade back then? What time frames did they trade? Okay, because usually most of the time, the evergreen strategies that we've been reading in books, Japanese candlesticks being in that category, all these theories and methods and strategies, they belong to completely different categories from what we're trying to achieve with these methods today. You cannot take an engulfing pattern, smash it on the 5-minute chart, and expect to make miracles. It will not work. That's why I'm telling you, take one thing, become absolutely proficient in that very single thing. Learn anything you can get your hands on regarding the subject. There will be a lot of misinformation, there will be a lot of bullshit, pardon my French, but at the end of the day, you will have a very broad understanding of this specific candle pattern. How, where, how often, how much money, drawdown, everything. Then you move on to the next one. And once you complete all 10, 15, 20 patterns and you understand how each of them works and you have an idea how to make money out of each of these patterns or not make money and take it out of the equation, then you move on to the next subject. That's the bottom line here. Do not immediately trade with real money. The idea is simple. You buy something, software strategy, trading method, doesn't matter. You buy something, you go over the materials, you go over the videos, fantastic. Now you're an expert after 3 days, after 17 hours of video materials. Let's jump to live trading. Let's put my 5 years of savings into this thing and then you lose 5, 10, 20, 50, $100,000, euros. Yens, I don't know what you're trading. Doesn't work this way. If you're watching, I don't know, expert drivers, do you think after 10 hours of watching someone who's been driving out there on the actual track for years, do you think you're good enough as him or her to go ahead and take your car and do the same thing? What are you doing, people? Take whatever you've learned, put it on a demo account, start practicing. YouTube books are not the real world. They give us the theory, they give us the information, but this is not the real world. If you don't trust me, go ahead and do it yourself. You will lose money. I guarantee you that. You can quote me if you want. I guarantee you, you will lose money. There is no way in hell you can take something that you've never heard before, learn it for a day, 2, or a week, and start making money consistently after using it 10, 15, 20 hours. No way. Every strategy, no, not every strategy, let's get away from the trading world for a second. Any skill in the world takes time to practice. Even the simplest thing has this very specific detail. The devil is in the details, right? Unless you have enough experience with that or someone comes and teaches you this, it will take time for you to understand and see for yourself these things. If you cannot guarantee yourself that you're a consistent trader, and we're back to patience here, for months, not weeks, what are you doing trading live money? You have no business trading live money until you can prove to yourself. No one else cares about your money, okay? No one else. You gotta prove it to you, not to me, not to your wife, not to your kid, not to your dog, to you. Prove it, you can make money, put some money live, start slowly building and growing. Important one. Trading is a business of statistics. It's all about making more than you lose to keep the curve going up. However, you can't rely on statistics if you're supposed to trade the 15-minute chart and you're a part-time trader. Why? Because then you miss out on trades that you were supposed to take winners or losers, and then the statistics mean absolutely nothing. You will be much better trading the higher time frames where you will rarely miss setups even if part-time trading your strategy. What do I mean by that? Let's say that you spot a pattern. You start manually backtesting this pattern because it's not codable for some reason, okay? You go back 2-3 years, backtested, looks perfect. Okay, now let's go ahead and apply to live trading, put some money on that. Let's see what happens, how much it will return and whether the statistics of the forward test will fit and meet the statistics of the backtest, the manual backtest. What many people are missing, and then they wonder, oops, what happened, is that when you're doing that on the 15-minute chart and you're not a full-time trader, you're missing the opportunities in the trades that happened during the night, that happened during the time you were sick, that happened during the time you were working, that happened during the time you were walking your dog or taking your kid to school. How can it be a realistic expectation if this is happening? So make sure whatever your trading style is, it fits with your lifestyle, with your routine. Otherwise, it will not work. This is why it's super beneficial to start with the higher time frames. Super beneficial. When you're doing the 4-hour chart, for example, or daily chart, then you have enough time to not miss opportunities because things are happening a bit slower. You have time to assess the situation, especially if you're starting right now, you're a beginner. You need more time to go back to your notes, to go back to the video you've been watching. Is that correct? Is that not correct? Go ahead, check with your mentor. Check with people in the community. Guys, is this is divergence? Is this a false break? Is that correct? Okay, we have time. Let's analyze it in peace, no rush. We don't lose money. Trade management is as important as risk management. Yet, people are failing to follow the very simple logic of trade management. So the first part is very simple. If you're risking $1, there is no way when you're making $0.2 or $0.5 that you make money in the long run. In other words, you're stepping in a transaction, in a business transaction, where you understand in advance that you're investing more than the full potential, the full profit that you could be taking from this business transaction is less. How can you be that you buy, let's say, a house or an apartment that you want to flip in a few months or in a year, you pay 100K, 1 million, and you're expecting to sell it for 500,000. What's the logic in that? How can you be making money long run if you're doing that? This is what most people are doing when it comes to risk reward and win ratio. Now, this is a bit of a rabbit hole. I'm not going to get into that. This is a bit more advanced subject because there could be different scenarios here. But as a rule of the thumb, if you're just starting out, think about this about these statistics and numbers every time you're opening the trade. Your potential loss should be at least, actually your potential profit should be at least the same size as your maximum loss. So if your maximum loss is $1, the least you should be getting out of this transaction, out of this trade, is $1. The least. This way, you make sure there is some kind of balance in your trade. Okay? And again, a bit for the advanced people and advanced traders watching this, you understand what I mean here. But let's not get there because this video is not about that. The second crucial part about trade management, at least in my opinion, is that you need to learn how to manage, okay? If your strategy or your trading method suggests that position management should be done, you gotta understand how to do that. Now, there are a few cases here. Trade management might be required when there is unexpected news from the market. There is some natural disaster, like, I don't know, earthquake in Japan, for example, right? You gotta know, well, this is a bit extreme, but you get the point. From a technical perspective, If you're trading and there is divergence against you, or you're hitting a very strong level, does your trading method suggest to do management or not? Because this is the part where many people are failing to understand how crucial this could be to your overall curve. Extremely crucial. I'm doing algorithmic development, and when I'm developing something, you put different modules. Let's say we have, I don't know, the simplest thing, moving average cross. Now I'm starting to put different modules to this moving average cross and see where the curve is going. Right? This is one of the steps. Just bear with me for a second. So having the trade management module implemented into this strategy, you have no idea how much impact this has. Very, very critical part, okay? Make sure you know what you're doing and don't just go with feelings. It feels like this is going to drop, let's do that or let's do this. Wrong. Have a very clear plan and understanding of what you should be doing, how you should be doing it in advance. Always in advance. If you're taking decisions right now, as the market is developing, emotions are in place. I'm guaranteeing you that 200%. If there is no plan set beforehand, emotions are in place. I don't care what you're saying behind the monitor at the moment. I'm sure about that. All right, number 9. Intraday trading is for advanced traders. This is a fact. If you're just starting out, please stay away from super, super intraday trading, okay? You're probably going to lose money, unfortunately. This is what the numbers are saying. It's not me, so don't be hating the delivery man. Okay, this is good. If you don't want to be crushed by the markets immediately, if not sooner, start with the higher time frames. Now, the higher time frames have a lot of benefits. We already mentioned some of them. So, first of all, they're much more reliable. Second of all, they fit into most, if not all, part-time traders, okay? Everyone goes to work, different routines during the day. If you're doing H4 and daily, for example, there will be always time for you to go back behind the monitor, analyze in peace, pull the trigger when you're supposed to do that, because things are happening slower. Reliability, time, what else do you need here? Okay, so that's about number 9. Number 10, have a realistic expectation for your trading business, profits wise. Now, you should have a realistic expectation, not just in trading, you should have realistic expectations about things in general in life. I'm not saying do not set goals, or I'm not saying do not dream about things. No, this is not what I'm saying. I'm just saying, learn to be present, to understand what's happening in the present, okay? If you're going to the gym and you're very serious about, you have some goal in the gym, right? To be that many kilos or to look like this or to whatever it is, you have a goal there. You cannot expect your body to transform in 3 or 4 weeks. You might be doing the job, but not having realistic expectations means you're going to fail, because after going for, I don't know, 3 weeks or 4 weeks and you don't see any significant change, you will drop it, because mentally you were prepared to see the changes immediately. This is the same mindset that many people are using in trading. They just got in this business, in this amazing black hole, which is swallowing money and people like nothing. And you're expecting to make 50 to 100% after a week or 3 months of studying? Seriously? We have banks, we have hedge funds, and these people are fighting for anywhere between 0. Some percentages up to 5, 10, 15, 20% per year. And then you're looking for 50 to 100 per month. Really? I don't think so. So this is what I have to share with you. If you have any questions, please message me in the comments below. I really hope that at least one person out of everyone watching this thing will be influenced, and it will take these things seriously, and it will apply them to his or her trading. And the bottom line here is to save some money for you guys, right? The bottom line is to save you some money, because if you approach trading with the right mindset, you could be the exception. You could be the person who never blew up his first account. You could be the person who, after 1 year of consistency, started making money almost immediately. Because 1 year, what is 1 year? What is the limit here? You're learning a business for life. And now we're starting to play with the proportions. If you get this thing correct from the first time you're sitting behind the PC, if you get this thing correct in 1 year, and you're trading $1,000, $5,000, $10,000 account, imagine what could be happening to you once you get more money. Because trust me, guys, people have money. They are willing to invest. This is more or less the easy part, to get investors. So now we're talking about proportions, but you have the know-how. Once you have the know-how, it's easy. Do not rush. Money will follow, and money always follows value. So if you have value, money will follow you, trust me. I'm wishing you a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.